is a company that is based in Belgium and exports worldwide. With five of its own divisions, I look after the UK division, and we manufacture in three different countries. So a majority of our products are manufactured in Slovakia. Those are the PuraTouch mouldings, which are predominantly covings and panel mouldings. We also extrude mouldings and three-dimensional products in our factory in Belgium, in Ostend. And we now also have a new factory just south of Moscow, which extrudes skirting boards as well. The products that we produce, I'd like to think, are world class. We are the UK's leading indirect lighting profile supplier. There are things that go from, say, 30 mil wide right through to, say, 170 mil wide, and they're used predominantly in reception areas of hotels or in restaurants, in coffers, in upmarket homes. Then we've got the coving that gets used a tremendous amount in both high-end and ordinary residential developments. Lower down the wall, you'd see panel mouldings, which can come in a variety of sizes. The dados, which sort of come in at hip heights. And then below that, we've even got stick-on complete panels where you don't need to do the mitering yourself. And then you go right down to the floor and you've got skirtings. We do some quite wacky three-dimensional shapes. Now, some of these are in tile form, like the W106 and W105, which are the curved and the envelope shapes. And then there are others which are 2 meters long, 250 mil wide. We've got the hill and the valley, and we've got the zigzag. And those profiles are really good because they're acoustically marvelous. So if you've got a noisy restaurant, they'll deaden the sound. I think what really sets us apart from our competition is the fact that the products are available. We have 400 references, both rigid and flexible profiles, which are on the shelf, normally on a 2 to 3 day lead time. If you could even have huge quantities, and that would be with you in a week. One thing I always smile at is somebody got an order when I was at a sales conference in Belgium for 8 miles of material, and it was delivered on the Friday after the meeting. So our competition very often gets an order and then thinks, we've got to make it, but we've got it in stock. And not only that, it's all in 2 meter lightweight lengths, so it can be carried around on site. If it gets dropped, it won't break. It's primed, so it doesn't absorb lots of paint like plaster products. And unlike wooden products, which in themselves are absolutely gorgeous, the problem is wood comes from trees. Trees grow branches, and those branches have little knots which let out resin and take the paint off from behind. So you put paint on our product, you'll get a perfect finish on the first or second coat. The one thing that people find as a great problem solver in our range is that we have lots of beautiful standard profiles, from skirting boards to covings and panel mouldings, but some of them come in this lovely flex format. So you can actually bend them against their grain, if there's such a thing, and you can bend them in and around bay windows. You can bend them in all different manner of ways. If you try and do a bay window with a wooden skirting, let me tell you what would happen. The guy would arrive on site on Monday, he would soak the timber skirting in some water for about half an hour, an hour, and he would repeat that every morning for 5 days. And hopefully, at the end of that week, he would be able to put skirting into the bay window. With this, just literally roll it out, put it along the wall with adhesive on the back, squeeze it into position. Job done in about 10 minutes. Find it fascinating in this day and age that you can stay in a posh hotel and it's got an MDF skirting and architrave in the bathroom. Do you know what happens? Within a few months of the installation going in, it absorbs the water, it blows, it looks hideous. So if you look on the stand behind me, you'll see a vase full of our skirting profiles that have been left in water since the beginning of the show. They're not going to rot, the paint's not going to peel off. It is just wonderful in those commercial environments, residential homes, places like that with long corridors that are steam cleaned. The product will not distort or absorb moisture. You could leave it out in the rain for 20 years, it wouldn't do any harm. The O in Orac stands for Ostend, and the research was originally done by a chap called Yves Tailleur, who is still with the company now. Great chap, very friendly guy, and he's quite visionary, so he was quite good at getting the manufacturing off the ground. Where we are even today, the factory originally started with just two staff and one assistant, and the original manufacturing was of table legs, and you know it didn't work. But the moment that Yves got involved in making ceiling roses, things suddenly started to work. And then Yves really started gearing up, getting involved in coatings and moulding. So historically the company was owned by the Tailleur family, and it still is today, even though it was expanded to cover not just little old Belgium but 90 countries around the world. We love coming to Decorex, and we keep coming back because people love it, and when they see what we can do, people are amazed every year about Flex, but we've been doing it for years. People are amazed about the 3D panelling, but we do more and more each year. And we got back to the hotel last night after day one. I would have to say that what was so exciting about yesterday was that we had virtually as many visitor discussions and people zapping on our telephones that they wanted more information than we had in all 4 days of last year. So Decorex moving to Olympia is fantastic. And at the end of the day, we had this very thankful email from somebody thanking us profusely that they'd taken the time to come and see us and they were not disappointed. I'd really find quite exciting about Orac is that I've been involved with them since the year 2000. I was selling about £250,000 worth of their product every year for 13 years, and then I sold my business and got involved. And every time I used to go to the factory, and I still go to the factory regularly now, there's something new in the factory at Belgium. But more than that, we've just invested, as I mentioned earlier, in the new factory just south of Moscow, and we're now looking to the future. We were early adopters at trying to get involved in, you know, being environmentally friendly, and the current commitment for the company is that by 2023 we will be carbon neutral. So we're actually assessing the reps' journeys, we're looking at how we produce things, and a lot of these profiles, you might think, oh well, there must be a lot of scrappage, but actually what happens is any scrappage that is created at the beginning of the production process, we actually now have €250,000 machine which grinds up all the materials, puts them back into the product again, so we end up with no waste out of our factory in Belgium. Whilst we're at Decorex today, which is predominantly aimed at interior designers, I do find that architects come along, and some of them aren't just thinking about the inside of a building, they're also thinking about the outside. Here we are in Olympia. If you go outside, you'll see some tall buildings. They have mouldings on the outside. They can be string courses or whatever, but we also do a range of mouldings, dental mouldings like this little fella here, which go up underneath a soffit, and they bring a little bit of Victoriana back into a new build. And that's something that if you're interested in, we do samples, and there's a little exterior book which you're welcome to have. We could show you the brochure, but these days more and more designers are finding Orac Decor at the website. And if you were to go on a page, you would find not only does it actually tell you the dimensions, it'll also give you pictures of the product installed, maybe several different pictures per product. And if you were to scroll down on that page, you'd also be able as a designer to plug into DWG or PDF files and just prop them into your drawing, which is fantastic. So you haven't got to wait for us to get back to you or anything. And then if you wanted something more to help you visualize your product, your project, all you'd have to do is speak to one of the girls behind us, and you might want three different profiles just to choose which size you wanted out of a particular range. Give us a call. We normally get our samples out the following day. So we do everything we can to help you visualise and create the interior of your dreams.